Oh, during the day, for the whole day, there are gates of Damascus, and there are gates of Jaffa, or contemporary Tel Aviv, and there are other gates from different parts of the world, people who are traveling to Jerusalem, entering, bringing something to sell, trying to go to this huge bazaar in Jerusalem. So they could exchange things, they could sell things. But then the sun goes down. All big gates in Jerusalem closed. And imagine this, someone came with camels, with horses, with many things to sell to Jerusalem, and it's already dark. You didn't make it. You didn't make this day. You have to wait for the next morning. Then the gates will be open so you can enter. So what you do? It's very dangerous to stay outside the walls of Jerusalem, because there is a desert and there are many thieves who can come and steal your goods and who can even kill you. For that reason, in the old Jerusalem, there was a small gate. It was not even a gate, it was just a hole in the wall. And it was called the Eye of a Needle. And to the present day, this hole exists. Right now it's in the church. It's in actually in the church of Alexander Nevsky, in Russian church outside the Russia. But anyway, it exists. So when we go to the pilgrimage, this is half of our program, but I usually take our group to see that place and that little hole. It's so small that an ordinary person can barely just squeeze. And you cannot bury anything. You cannot bury even your backpack. Not saying about camels and horses and huge things that you could have bring to Jerusalem. So those people who were outside the walls of Jerusalem had a choice. They could either stay outside, preserving their goods, but in that case, everything they brought could be stolen and they could be killed. Or they could at least save themselves, squeeze into Jerusalem, and leave everything else outside. So this analogy is very powerful. Because it can be applied for our spiritual life. Sometimes we want to walk a good path to salvation, but there are many things that are basically obstacles. They create problems for us to enter the kingdom of God. So this first step to perfection is to leave aside, to leave behind everything that interrupts us, that does not allow us to go further, to make a progress in Christian life. And this is our passions and sins. So this is the first step. But even if we came to the older age and we think to ourselves, we do not really have any substantial sins or passions, we just live this normal life, there is still another step that needs to be done. Okay, let's now talk about the second step. I remember then I was working at the Ukrainian Catholic University. Once our nuncio of Ukraine, nuncio of the Pope of Rome to Ukraine, he came to our university and he gave us a public speech. And he started his speech with those words. He said, in the past, I was also a nuncio in Belarus and Armenia, and now I'm in Ukraine. So all the places he mentioned were part of the Soviet Union. And he himself is from Italy. His last name is Gugerotti. And he said, what surprised me in all these years, when I met young people, when I meet with young people, I would usually just go on and ask, how are you? This is quite usual thing. Yes, you come and you say, how are you? How are you today? And most of the people coming from Soviet Union in the past, they would say, today I'm quite normal. It's a normal day. I feel normal. This is an unusual answer for Italian, and I think this is an unusual answer also for English speaking. It's not, yet usually you ask, how are you? How are you? I'm good, yeah, and or I'm not. I'm okay, at least okay. But normal, what does it mean normal? I'm normal. It's a normal day. This is an unusual answer for the United States or for Italy. But this is very, very common and usual answer for Ukraine, Russia, Belarus, Armenia, Georgia, and from this Georgia. this is quite the usual answer. Quite the usual answer. Why? Because in the Soviet Union, they wanted everyone to be the same. Just to live a mediocre life, just the usual life, uncommon life, normal life. You don't have to do something special, anything. People who are doing something special could be punished for that. It was not something that government would expect from you. You have to stay normal. And to have normal days and to live normal life. But this is not something that Jesus wants from us. In fact, the word saint can be translated as someone who is different, who is not like any other. We are all unique. We all have our own path to perfection. So it's important not to be a mediocre, but to do this next step in our life, and not only just to live our ordinary life, even if there are no substantial sins, but to do something special, to trust God and to let God lead us in our life, to have special relations with God, because sometimes we go to church, we pray, but it doesn't mean that we already have established our personal relations with God. That could be just customs, you know, like national customs. We have national feasts, and we have feasts in the church. So sometimes we come to church, we spend this 1 hour here, we listen or not, we participate in the banquet, we receive gifts, and that's all. That's our religion. But this is not what God expects from us. This is not our religion, just to attend some kind of a meeting, even religious meeting. God wants us to establish personal relations with Him, that He may influence your life, that you experience that God is alive, and He acts through you, and He wants not only yours, but you, your heart. It wants you to involve your life in the life of Christian community. He wants to be part of you, and He wants you to be part of His divine life. But that's why He says to this young man, this is not enough only that you have lived a righteous life. Step forward, make a next step, come after me. And He says to us, come after me. Allow myself to be a part of your life, to act in your life. This is what is important. Actually, on this Friday, we made this movie night. We made this movie night with young people, and we watched a movie, Facing the Giants, and it was exactly about that. There was a man who lived an ordinary life. He was very good. He was good. He didn't do anything bad. But for some reason, his life was not successful until he said, I trust you, God. I entrust everything I have to you. You have all my life. You have all my hopes. And now, start to act in my life. I trust you. I dedicate all my life to you. Everything I do is for your glory. Now show me glory through my weakness. That's what we have to do. This is the next step. Next step to perfection. Just a few words in Ukrainian. Ви знаєте, мої діти вже знають, що коли вони приходять зі школи, і я питаюся їх, як був сьогоднішній день, і коли вони часто відповідають нормально, то я дуже злюся через це. Тому що я не розумію, що таке нормально. Що є нормально? Нормально добре чи нормально зле? Має бути або так, або так. Щось сказати окремо, що сталося сьогодні, нормально не означає нічого. Або навпаки, щось означає. І означає те, що ти вважаєш, що якщо нічого особливого в твоєму житті не сталося, все було як звичайно, то це добре, так і треба. Ми не для того живемо, щоб в нас все було нормально. Тому що християнське життя це до певного сенсу є ненормальне життя. Чи святий Миколай, якого пам'ять ми сьогодні будемо святкувати, він був нормальним? Нормальна людина іде вночі і занесе золото людям, яких ти не дуже знаєш? Нормальна людина такого не зробить. Чи Йосифат, якому присвячена ця церква, не міг собі жити спокійним життям, його батько хотів, щоб він був купцем, щоб він мав багато грошей, нормально собі жити. Він міг це зробити, але він вибрав життя до нашого служіння і в кінці, в молодому віці, віддав своє життя заради справи, за яку його багато хто критикував і не любив, і його вбили. Чи він вів нормальне життя? Сьогодні ми святкуємо пам'ять так званих праотців. Це неділя праотців. Авраам, Ісаак, Яків, Мойсей. Чи Авраам жив нормальним життям? Бог йому сказав, вийди з своєї країни, йди невідомо куди і веди свою сім'ю туди. Це нормально? Це не є нормально. Я така подумав про Авраама. І те, що ми з вами тут є, поїхали з України зовсім недавно. Ми там також спокійно і гарно жили. Чи це нормально, що ми сюди приїхали? Ненормально. Нормальніше було лишатися і нічого не робити. Тому не бійтеся у вашому житті того моменту, щоб щось зробити. Якщо Бог вас до чогось кличе, не бійтеся. Можливо, Він кличе, бо є для цього певна причина, бо Він для вас щось приготував. Не живіть цим нормальним життям. Живіть життям особливим, бо Бог хоче, щоб ми йшли до святості і щоб ми всі були послухані. Ім'я Отця і Сина і Святого Духа. Амінь. Слава Ісусу.
Господи, Боже, 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 Господ Oh. Amen. going on, and I think in the future there will be even more.
come and we welcome you all. I'd like also to thank everyone who supported us, because our son Ilya had an operation this Monday on appendix, and thank you for prayers and support. And I'd like also to thank everyone who came yesterday to decorate our church hall, especially young people, and especially thank Mary. I thank Mary for preparation of this play, Christmas play and St. Nicholas play, which we are about to see. And the last thing, but not the least, I'd like to greet Pani Maria with her birthday, because it was yesterday. She didn't want us to know and to announce this. But still, she's part of our family, and we wish you many, many happy years. Моя дитя.